just about 5 minutes away from the finals of the 110 hurdles. So let's spend a moment in time with Roger Kingdom.
City filled with light, glass, and high spires. Behind the new spire, a kingdom. Roger Kingdom is the owner of Olympic gold. Within the city of Pittsburgh, he has hardly become an Olympic hero. An upset winner at the 84 Games, his biggest hurdle has been getting beyond the shadow of Greg Foster and Ronaldo Nehemiah.
I'm a gold medalist, but sometimes whenever I pull up in a meet, I really don't get that impression. And I don't know, I just... In a sense, anyone else would get disappointed, but I think that's why I keep excelling and keep doing better, because I know that I'm not at that point yet. You know what I mean? Where I'm going to grab the headlines or all the limelight the way that Nehemiah and Greg are.
In 1988, neither Foster nor Nehemiah are in the Seoul to overshadow Kingdom. He's an old challenge still unanswered.
I am disappointed in that they're not competing, and maybe one day we can all hook up again and top shape all three of us. And we can really see who's going to be the best hurdler.
But if I got the toe up, then that will pull it in.
In the year leading up to the 88 Olympics, Roger Kingdom was far from the world's best hurdler. With a debilitating hamstring injury, Roger was not even ranked among the top 10 Americans. The Kingdom's course, which brought Roger back into top shape, includes Joy Shepherd and Albert Kennedy. Shepherd has a dual role. Not only is she Roger's coach, but also his girlfriend. He is the only major athlete that she has ever coached.
Good, much better.
Albert Kennedy's role is more technical.
Did you think about it?
He's like the trainer that comes in before a major fight and just fine-tune the athlete to make sure that everybody is clicking at the right moment.
Yeah.
But if I'm out here, then it's...
The Kingdom's matriarch is Christine Kingdom. She never misses a meet and holds a profound influence over her son's life.
She's my own personal psychologist and also my spiritual leader, because whenever I have a problem, I can go to her and I can talk to her about my problems, and I can get exactly what I want to hear. You know, that those words that always sprout my confidence.
I tell them if they have a problem or anything like that, talk to me. Let me know what the problem is. Even if it's nothing I can do, at least I can be a good listener.
Nice and easy.
Off the track, Roger spends time at the Pittsburgh YMCA. He helps build more than just confidence with the local youngsters. One lane assignment Roger likes to draw is at the bowling alley. With a 190 average, Roger takes the game seriously and harbors ideas of joining the PBA tour after his track career. But for now, Roger is striving once again for Olympic gold and hoping to place himself in the record book alongside Lee Calhoun as the only men to win two gold medals in the high hurdle.
I'm just hoping that I can leave such an impression on the people's mind that once I'm finished or I get to the point where I can't really excel the way that I'm doing now, that they will remember what I've done. You know, that I could be a mini legend. And a mini legend at this point would suit me fine.